Hello everyone, welcome to today's session. Today I want us to look at the value chain, the value chain model as it was coined by Michael E. Porter. These are some of the models that you're supposed to be good at as you get yourself into business. If you want to have a business that will be having a bigger market share, bigger profitability, simply a better competitive advantage, always strive to run your model, to run your business on the basis of these nine activities of Michael Porter's value chain model. So under Michael Porter's value chain model, we have five primary activities, and then we have got four secondary activities. Four secondary activities. Now, ladies and gentlemen, when it comes to Michael Porter's primary activities, what are we supposed to be having? We are supposed to be taking on our raw materials under inbound logistics. How do we, ladies and gentlemen, store our raw materials? What kind of warehousing systems do we have to ensure that our raw materials are preserved in a way that they will not lose value with time? Ladies and gentlemen, if you look at, for example, the hotels sector, you'll get some hotel here selling, for example, lunch, say fish and a few accompaniments for 5,000 Kenya shillings. Go across just the other side of the road, you'll get another small hotel or restaurant selling the same type of lunch, fish with accompaniment, but for only 400 Kenya shillings. And you'll be surprised, even the one that is selling at a lower price could be having superior quality. Perhaps even their food is not refrigerated. But ladies and gentlemen, if you want to have always a competitive advantage, where you're able to charge more and you still get more people, there are things that you need to get right. And one of them is this inbound logistics. Go, for example, ladies and gentlemen, to a hotel like Hilton. Look at the backside there, how they have their raw materials coming in, if it's fish, coming in refrigerated cars, etc., etc. So we must really get it well in terms of our raw materials preservation. Raw materials preservation. How do we bring them on the road, on the air? How do we store them in-house, etc., etc., etc. The moment we do that very well, then we'll be able to add value onto our systems, which automatically will mean that this profit segment, which is basically the segment of our competitive advantage, it will be taken care of, it will be bigger. From there, ladies and gentlemen, we go to the operations. And the operations as a second primary Michael Porter's activity, we look at the conversion of raw materials into finished goods. How do we convert? Do we have, in this case here, for example, automated systems? How is our infrastructure of conversion? If you want to have a competitive advantage, ladies and gentlemen, we must score on this activity very well. Let's try as much as possible to convert these things in using automated systems. Then we've got outbound logistics. How do we distribute these goods here to our consumers? How do we distribute these goods to our consumers? Do we have a strong distribution system? Are we that kind of a company whose products will always be absent, whose products will always not be found by consumers? If you look at these big firms like Coke, big firms are known globally, they have very strong distribution systems, very strong distribution systems. Ladies and gentlemen, if you look at what is happening currently in the market, if you are producing a superior product, fast moving products here, you'll always be better off outsourcing these distribution logistical systems. Just outsource. But ensure that you are in control, simply because it's still a a primary activity. From there, we go to sales and marketing. And sales and marketing, basically, how do you publicize your product in a way that you'll be able to get a competitive advantage? How do you publicize your product? How do you publicize your product? So remember here, you need to remember, you need to know, like the four P's of marketing. The pricing, the promotion. You need, ladies and gentlemen, to remember all those things. How do you place your items in a way that, if for example, it's in a supermarket, they are visible, they should be visible. Don't just deliver your products to a supermarket and then you expect them really to be kept in a way that customers who walk in will be able to see. No, if it's proper sales and marketing, brand visibility is a key thing. And then we have the after sales services. After sales services, basically, we are positioning ourselves in a way that these consumers outside there should be able to know that we are really caring, that our work never ended at just selling to them. But post-sales, you're still following them. You're still following them. We want to have warranties, which are working. It's only by doing that that people will be able to know that our firm is a serious organization, Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you have this very well, trust you me, this profit section, the competitiveness in the market, your market share will be taken care of. But still, if you want to fly higher, go to these secondary activities which support each of these primary activities. To remember the secondary activities, normally talk of PIF, downwards PIF. So we have procurement, we have infrastructure, we have technology, we have HRM, like human resource management. To be able, ladies and gentlemen, here to have proper staff, you need an HR manager, human resource manager, whose primary responsibility will be to hire people and ensure that we retain the best talent within the organization. And of course, not forgetting the concept of continuous professional development of our staff. Continuous professional development of our staff. Ladies and gentlemen, from there we can go to technology. Under technology, we are supposed to ensure, as we said here, that we automate our processes. So automation of our processes. If you look at those companies that are doing very well outside here, they have automated most of their processes. The manual systems, ladies and gentlemen, are not very good in terms of internal controls. If you want internal controls, your internal control systems, which will ensure that your major objective is met in the long run, ensure, ladies and gentlemen, that your systems are what you automated, your production systems are automated. From there, ladies and gentlemen, we go to infrastructure. So on the infrastructure, this basically, again, includes the company's systems. The company's systems. As you begin your business, ladies and gentlemen, for example, the accounting department, you can get just a small system like the QuickBooks. But also remember, as you grow, what should you be looking at? Things like the ERP, SAP systems. So under infrastructure, we are looking at, ladies and gentlemen, the systems, you're looking at the infrastructural systems of running your business. How do you do your planning, your quality control? So we need all that infrastructure to be there for us to be able to boost our internal control systems. Lastly, we go to procurement. And the procurement, of course, you know, we need to have most of the staff here supporting these primary activities being procured. And the procurement, remember, yeah, the major objective should be to procure materials, items of a high quality at an optimal cost, at the best cost. So what you're saying, ladies and gentlemen, what will give you a competitive advantage outside there, such that you'll be able to charge a higher price and still get consumers coming to consume your products here, which are expensive, is to ensure that your Michael Porter's wheel rolls forward on the premise of these nine activities. Otherwise, thank you very much. I hope you guys will subscribe to this YouTube channel. which basically is out there to ensure that you get the requisite business skills for you to run your businesses effectively. RCM Online College offers such courses at a cost-effective price. So please, if you want to reach out to us, don't hesitate. Just get us at 0719 525,000. Thank you very much.